To replace your rear brake pads, you will need to begin by safely lifting and supporting your vehicle. For additional assistance with that task, please follow the link provided at the end of this video. In this image, you can see the rotor, red arrow, the caliper, green arrow, and the brake pads, yellow arrow, one showing and one on the other side. The caliper, green arrow, has the parking brake line, red arrow, and the brake line, yellow arrow, attached to it. You do not need to remove either of these lines to change the brake pads. The caliper parking brake assembly is attached to the caliper mount by two 13mm bolts attached to two 15mm guide bolts, yellow arrows. To remove the caliper, use a 15mm wrench to counterhold the guide bolts, yellow arrow, while removing the 13mm bolts, red arrows. The 13mm bolts are micro-encapsulated from Volkswagen and considered single-use only. Pull the caliper, red arrow, off from its mount, leaving the brake pads, yellow arrow. Depending on the condition of the pads and whether they have anti-squeal backs, you may need to use a fair amount of force to wiggle and force them off. Hang the caliper up out of the way, red arrow, with a bungee cord or piece of rope. Never let the caliper hang by the brake line. Remove the old pads, red arrow, one shown, one behind the rotor, from the clips, yellow arrow, in the mount. Remove and clean the clips, yellow arrow. It's a good idea to replace these when changing your pads. Pull the guide pins and rubber boots from the mount, yellow arrow. Inspect the pin for any dirt, debris, or rust. Clean the bolt and apply new grease as needed. Inspect the boots for rips and other damage. Repair as needed and reinstall the guide bolts into the mount. On the rear, the pistons must be pushed and turned at the same time. There are several options available to you here, but you will need to use a special caliper piston tool. You can buy the tool, Pelican sells them, or most local auto parts stores have a free or minimal cost tool rental program. The tool consists of several pucks that have pins that sit in the notches in the piston, red arrow. Place the right puck for your piston on top of it. Install the rest of the tool and slowly compress the piston while it is turning back into the caliper. Before you begin compressing the calipers, check your brake fluid reservoir. Compressing the caliper piston will cause brake fluid to travel back up into the reservoir, and you need to make sure there's room for it, red arrow. Carefully clean around the reservoir before opening it, as you do not want any dirt or debris getting into it. Be prepared to use a turkey baster or a fluid pump to extract some brake fluid if necessary. Make sure whatever you use is clean. You do not want any contaminants getting in the fluid. The caliper is now ready to install the new pads. Installation is the reverse of removal. You may also want to spray the back of the brake pads with some anti-squeal paste. Some brands of pads may come with anti-squeal pads already attached to the rear surface. Anti-squeal pads can also be purchased separately as sheets that are peeled off and stuck on the rear of the pads. When finished both sides, press the brake pedal repeatedly to make sure that the pads and pistons seat properly. Also, make sure you top off the master cylinder brake fluid reservoir if necessary. Brake pads now need to be bed to the rotors or broken in a little. Your braking performance will be diminished until this is done, usually around 100 miles. Please bed your new pads in accordance with the manufacturer's directions of the pads you purchased. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe to our channel and check out another video in this series.